I am very excited to make this video. Hugsy, are you?
Yeah.
And that's saying a lot. Hey guys, this is Anthony and welcome back to another video. And it's 11 o'clock right now, but who cares? And it is time for another Q&A. Who knows, I might even make this a series, but maybe not, because who knows how many questions you guys have on you. How about if we get to 15 likes, I might do another one. So welcome to Huffing Boy Knows. Huffing Boy knows when he's answering cues, giving some answers, delivering news. Took me about 30 seconds to write that song. Hopefully Disney doesn't sue me for copywriting, bottom line. Actor Aaron Booth says, can we ask you questions Jeopardy style? Well, what is, no, how would that work? This is not trivia, it's a Q&A. Awkward Sense 86 says, did you and Vincent play any pranks on any of the older newsies when you were on tour? It's kind of vice versa. They made a thing where they were filming scaring Vincent and I, and we were terrified. Aaron 65 asks, cats or dogs? Well, I mean, I have a cat, so... Okay, please don't tell Glitter. I'm a dog person, I'm sorry. I'm letting down my cat. Willa Jane Shaw asks, how does this picture make you feel? I want to tell the truth. It's cool that you got to face swap with your cat. I've always wondered why I was a dog person. Nicole says, what's your dream role? So I would like to play Monty Navarro, Cornelius Hackle, and Timon. Put on your Sunday clothes, there's lots of world out there. Joshua Burridge asks, who's your fave person with the name Josh Burridge? What do you think? It's one I toured with. It's one I'm great friends with. It's the one that has way more likes than the actual Q&A tweet. Natalie says, how did you get into theater? So Newsies made me passionate about it. You've heard that story a bunch of times. But I just did it to try it out, because Celia did shows before, and it ended up being very fun. Bay Tyler Cook wants to know what's my favorite ice cream flavor, and I would say cookies and cream. Yeah, enough said. How is it having Celia Rosenthal as a sister? Well, my honest opinion is it's kind of rough, it's kind of bad. Oh wait, Celia is the one who asked that question! No, I was joking! Mike3K asks if I have any upcoming shows. I do not have any upcoming shows, but who knows, maybe sometime. Could be. Who knows?
Oh my gosh, can you stop with the singing for 1 second?
Hey, you're my stuffed animal, so you're gonna have to get used to my singing. This is my bedroom, this is my channel, this is my Q&A, so you can either be used to my singing or leave. I think Hugsy just left me. Oh well. Always a Newsy asks, who would you want to play in Hamilton? I actually thought about this, and I would want to play Lafayette / Jefferson, because I love, like, the presence and the energy and the songs and the lyrics he sings, and I love the overall... The cold always bothered us every day, like, for real. We're getting, like, allergies and headaches, and ain't nobody got time for that. But yeah, I love the overall role. Theater Emily wants to know what my favorite Harry Potter character is, and I think I'd say Hermione, because I think she makes great choices, and I think she's really brave and really smart, and Emma Watson's very pretty. Caesar Rosenthal's, by the way, that's an amazing account, wants to know what my favorite part about being in New York is, and I think the overall, like, friends we have there is amazing. Like, we have, like, a lot of great friends that live here and are near here. And, of course, other parts about living in New York is amazing, but I love having that here. Kelly Collins 26 asks, if you could gender bend any role in any show and play the female role, which would you choose? So there are probably a lot of roles that I've wanted to play that are female, but I can only think of one right now, and that's Morales on Chorus Line, because I love what I did for Love, and I love her character and everything, but she sings Nothing, which is one of my favorite songs all time, and I would love to perform that song. So yeah, I say, for now, Morales. One of my friends from California asks, when are you visiting California again? Aw, well, you can look forward to that in just a few years. Greg Garcia asks, do you want to be an all-star actor, like, when you grow up? Yes. Marie Grossman asks, what's my favorite show I've seen, tour or Broadway? Well, ta-da! MaraBud27 asks, if you could be anywhere in the world right now, where would you be? Well, let's see. I'm happy where I am.
But the answer's Paris.
Mikayla, hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. She says, your favorite place in California and your favorite musical songs right now. So obviously I love LA and all the other big ones, but the surprising answer is actually kind of Vacaville, which is Cowtown, and you might know about it if you've seen the California Visit, because it's just like really close to my heart. And my musical songs, probably Nothing, and They Can't Take That Away From Me, and like all the songs from like Wicked and King and I love like a lot. Disnerd of the Opera asks, what did you like best about being on the Newsies tour / favorite memory? Well, I break that down in the top 15 Newsies on tour moments. Be sure to check that out. Shameless plug. Spoiler alert, it's meeting all of you guys at the stage door. Broadway Daily 24607 asks, you're stuck on an island. What do you do to survive? The sad truth is I probably wouldn't survive. I'd probably run around screaming hopelessly and be smashed by the Bigfoot in the Monty Python movies. This is for you and Silly if she's doing it with you. Who is your favorite Friends character? Ah, it switches so many times for me. I love all of them, really. I think maybe Joey, though. Let's see with Celia.
My favorite Friends character is Joey. How you doing?
EVPSD10 asks, what's your favorite fast food restaurant? In-N-Out, is that even a question? David Annex asks, favorite day of the week? Well, whatever day it is today, live in the now. Always live in the now. Cameron Edwards asks, if you had to pick between singing, dancing, and acting, what would you pick? I'd say acting. Because you can get in touch with your emotions. Funny Looking Dogs asks about my favorite favorite memory about working with Jacob. Jacob is a great person to hang out with, so there's a lot. But before we went on each show, we always had a little exchange, whether it was like a smile or like, let's do this. And those were really nice. I miss those. Jennifer Hansa asks, what is the best advice you've ever received and who gave it to you? Well, it was from my parents. They told me, Anthony, get some table manners. That's a serious answer. What is the story behind your username, HoofingBoy100? I've always had the nickname HoofingBoy because I did my little tap dancing thing, but it was before I took tap dancing lessons that I've had that nickname. And HoofingBoy100 had a number and it just sounded nice, so I picked that. And I know a lot of you guys are thinking I wanted to be a horse, but really it's tap dancing. Now watch me, Nay Nay. I should get arrested. I already made that joke. Do you have any cats?
Yeah, he does.
Favorite onstage mess up? Any funny stories about missed clues, dropped lines, prop malfunctions, falling on stage, anything? Okay, I don't know if I want to share this one. I'm so sorry, Dan DeLuca. Well, it was in Carrying the Banner. He was on the tower, and he forgot the lyrics to It's a Crooked Game We're Playing, because we've been doing it a lot of times. Brain farts happen. And so he said, la 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 la, when we'll never lose. And Vincent and I were in the dressing room, and we heard it through the monitor, and we were like, what? So when we were backstage, we were just looking at Dan, and he was just like, I forgot the words. It was so funny. Jefferson or Burr? Burr. Theaterner98, by the way, I don't know if I'm saying all of your names. I'm sorry if I accidentally forget to say them. Says, favorite show currently on Broadway? That's so hard. I love so many of them right now. I'll answer that in a different video coming soon. What's the lowest note you could sing? I don't know. Let's see. So I think that's gonna wrap up Hoofing Boy Knows. I'm sorry if I couldn't get to your questions. I got a lot of questions and I got a lot of repeats too. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you are not sad about Hugsy. And I will see you later. Goodbye! Whoa!